All right, so I'm not sure if it's just like people who went up to talk to the police that kind of posted up there. We'll zoom in a little bit. Take a look. So that's an unmarked police vehicle we saw earlier with a few other people around it. Was there more police vehicles up there?
Well, yes, the more we're getting there, there was BIA.
Yep. All right, so like over this hill, it sounds like there's more police vehicles lining up now, according to some folks who just drove up. So we're just live streaming on top of the my vehicle here. I'm not gonna move anywhere. I'm just gonna kind of hang out and see what happens. Again, prayers here, construction site there. There's a little bulldozer. And, yeah. So yeah, there's more. Here comes how low this even like this helicopter's been recording. Are just really low. Just cruising along. Hey, what's up, Hugh Minol? Hugh Minol, thanks for those kind words from Minnesota. Yeah, let's get hang out on this vehicle and see what happens here. There's another. That helicopter. It's a blue one. I heard it's a new one. Usually there's been a yellow one out here. There's now two helicopters that have been circling around since I arrived. Again, big ups to everyone who supported Unicorn Riot. You're the reason that I was able to come back. So thanks a lot. Along with Unicorn Riot, big thanks to you all, to us all, I suppose. Yeah, it looks like they're just holding the ground. They did like a four-directional prayer at the previous site they were on, and now it looks like they're doing another one on this site. My connection isn't great, I apologize. I'm just gonna try to hold it a little steady and just kind of hold the frame and just gonna wait here. So if you have questions or anything like that, please drop them in the chat. I'll do my best to answer them. I have a pretty good working knowledge of sort of like what's been going on around the Dakota Access Pipeline here in North Dakota. And also noting that there's an action recently in called Mississippi Stand Camp, right at the side of Mississippi, actually in Iowa. I was a little confused. I was kind of when I first heard of it. But yeah, in Iowa, they stopped construction a few days ago. And so there's actions like this kind of happening all along the pipeline route in Iowa and here in North Dakota, where people are going out into this. They see how they're praying. And it looks like all the workers are gone. And it also looks as though the sort of aerial security and so on was kind of giving advance warning to different sites, because as the sites were kind of convoy reached different sites, it looked like the workers had just left. Like things were still kind of in their place. But they were kind of just told to leave before anyone ever got there. Kind of, that's what it looked like anyways. So again, you have these folks still in the distance, right? Are praying there. This is, from my understanding, the one road in that we're on here. Goes up to this little hill, and you got an unmarked vehicle, and I don't know who is standing around there, but that's what's on that way. Looks like a few more people. And then over here, supposedly that's a dead end that way. Oh, yeah, let's get out of that. And so yeah, just enjoying the okay. Yeah, I can see a BIA SUV behind that police officer. It's a vehicle right there, it's backing up. It's a Bureau of Indian Affairs vehicle. Looks like it might be taken away. It looks like they are out of here. Maybe consulting, not sure what they were doing.
Away.
Alright, you got a good shot of this. Plant has a little pot at the side. I don't know if I can actually. There's a little pod. You can see a surveillance pod, maybe. Oh, we lose it. You can hear singing in the distance. Again, I can't record prayers, and so not super much point to get much closer. And anybody who has the good old map system on their computer, if you're on a computer, this is west of Highway 6 right now. I'm not exactly sure what road.
Oh, look at the sky.
Circling. Thanks for the like. Again, it's probably not the most exciting stream, but I just want to show just kind of what's going on. Right here's some grasshoppers in the high grass here right near me. Doubt you can make it out. I'm sure it's not very clear on this cell phone cam when I zoom. But you look back behind that left tire, there's a little black dot, and that's the kind of pod, I think it has their camera sticking out of it. And so they're banking around, banking left, and kind of pointing that camera down towards where the folks are gathered praying. They've been doing that for a minute. No idea how good that camera is, but it's up there. I'm sure it's pretty good. Vehicles now over here. I'm not sure who is over there now. Those are three vehicles now. Pointing and discussing something. Thanks for the other like. So I'm not sure how clear my voice is. I'm not really sure how clear the stream is. It looks like it's kind of bouncing all over the place. I have a feeling it's probably pretty pixelated. I apologize for that. But again, we kind of are in the middle of nowhere here in North Dakota. You can see the surrounding landscape is a lot of just vastness. Let's see if I can get you this pod here. All right. Here we go. Try again. All right, back left here. There, I see it. Maybe just right there. Boom! Perfect. I thought you saw it, but I saw it pretty good. Okay, so somebody over here. It might be a press of some sort. You can see they opened their back hatch. I'm not sure. I can't see. Don't got binocs. Maybe they have binocs. I got it. Oh, what's up? Anyone's just joining? Thank you. So at the previous site before this, they were there for probably about an hour praying. I assume that's probably going to be the sort of same thing they're doing here. The AV starts jittering around a little bit. The audio and video, I'm not sure how that's doing. I get one more check. I have a feeling it's kind of lagging a little bit. Hey, what's up, Chase AC? Thanks for watching me on our platform, Uniform Riot. And yeah, again, we're just kind of like standing back a little bit, letting folks pray. Yeah, that's a lot of responsibility, Chase. Get some shade here. I'm kind of cooking. Some people are starting to leave the site. Alright, I'm gonna slide down here. Ooh. I'm destroying my car. Destroying my vehicle. Hey, what's up, anyone's joining? Kind of want to see what's up here. Another police vehicle just pulled up this way. Looks like people are leaving the site now. Trying to get a little bit of a magnifying device. Yeah, it looks like... Let me zoom in here. Yeah, it looks like three Highway Patrol vehicles, four officers. So they're standing around. They're going back in their vehicles now. At least one with a pair of binoculars on the right, scoping out something behind them. Yeah, three vehicles, four officers. Maybe five, I'm not sure. One's a BIA vehicle, is pulling out on the side there. Sorry about that. Yeah, it looks like they're backing out now. Yeah, Hunter asked, it's pretty pretty remarkable land, North Dakota. So the eastern side of North Dakota is very flat, the Great Plains, if you will. Pretty intense, just vastness and vastness. And then out here you have a little bit of rolling hills. You can kind of see them out there in the distance. And this like beautiful vistas. And the further you go west, the sort of more craggy the land becomes a little bit until you get to the Badlands, which is pretty phenomenal if you've never seen it before. Really beautiful as well. Alright, so I think the prayer is over. I kind of want to try to drive out with this thing streaming, but I'm not sure how well that's going to work. So yeah, so the police stayed back the whole time, way over there on the hill, with pretty hardcore, well, you know, I don't know hardcore, but you know, it's surveillance. Yeah, then earlier they had two helicopters and a plane, now they just have a plane. Alright, so let's see if anyone's getting back to the vehicles. I'm gonna get in my vehicle as well. Do yet. I might try to set up so we can drive out live and just kind of see stuff together. It's gonna take me a second to do that. I'm gonna put some stuff away. Hey, what's up? Anyone's just joining? There's just a sort of prayer by Water Protection to move down to the Dakota Access Pipeline construction site in North Dakota. There's no workers in sight from what I've been seeing as these folks went out to do their thing. Just there was so much surveillance that it kind of looked like the police were kind of warning workers before they got there to get them out of there. And the different sites that they went to, things looked like they were still just kind of like recently being worked on. Yeah. It's hot. No, I can't see the inside of my vehicle. Congrats. Oops. Oh, man. Yeah, so everyone's dispersing now. I'm gonna go down, I guess. Just give me 1 second here. I'll get out so it's like a nice scenic view instead of the inside of my vehicle. Alright, what's up everyone? This is Lorenzo with the Unicorn Ride. We are in North Dakota where the sort of resistance against the Dakota Access Pipeline has been ongoing now for months. Today, a group of water protectors left the camps, went out to two various construction sites, went onto the sites and prayed at both of them, stopping construction. As they left, they were followed by two helicopters and also a surveillance plane. And then along the route, look over here, there was a lot of police officers sort of like following along and just kind of like watching as well. And that was basically what went down today. I'm going to go down for a little bit real quick. Thank you all for your support. If you do want to continue to support Unicorn Riot, just go to unicornriot.ninja, click support our work, and drop something into the bucket. All the money goes back into just making sure that we can keep people out here. So again, that's support our work at unicornriot.ninja. You can also follow us on Twitter and on Facebook at @UR_ninja on Twitter and unicornriot.ninja on Facebook. Fresh water. Oh, the other like really kind of interesting event was at the previous site, a crop duster flew over after everyone had moved off and sprayed it. And so people were like running to their vehicles, sort of like not sure what was being sprayed. And it was really, I don't know, I've never seen anything like it. That was pretty random occurrence. I have all these folks just kind of out to the side. I'm sure they're just kind of hanging out. Doors open. Alright, well, I'm just trying to see what to do. Part of me really wants to try to drive out, but I don't really want to drive out for a second here. So we're going to let people leave. We're almost there. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get someone else to hold it as I drive out, so you can kind of see the police that I've gathered. Another police vehicle just pulled up. Not sure why. What they really plan to do now? Everyone's leaving, but who knows? We're about to find out. Yep. Along the way, huh? Oh, there's the bear cat. There is the bear cat. And they just put the hatch up. Oh, now I gotta walk over there. And there is an MRAP behind it. Ah! So there's a. Okay, so we got a bear cat here. And then looks like another vehicle behind it. You see some bunch of police vehicles just pulled up. And what looks like an armored, yeah, and so they have a Bearcat and an MRAP. Ready to go over there and take a look. So this showed up. I don't think this was here last time. Hello. I have no idea. I've been sitting there the whole time. This is walking up here now. Walking up with my press pass out. I've been on the road the whole time, live streaming to you all, so you all saw where I was standing this whole time. Now I'm just kind of walking up to take a look. See, I'm probably not gonna get super close. Looks like the police have made a soft line in front of this vehicle as it moves up. Lots more police vehicles just showed up. So I hope somebody uniform rides watch right now. I can screen cap this. So plane overhead, Bearcat and police vehicle. Discussing with this vehicle. I know what's going on. I haven't done anything illegal, so I'm gonna walk up closer. Not really, I'm kind of alone, so I'm not gonna walk up super close. But yeah, so they have a lot of police officers now. They have two armored vehicles. There's somebody in the cupola of that one with a binoculars and started checking out what's going on. Doesn't look like other vehicles started coming this way. You have this helicopter back. It was gone for a little bit, must have gone refueled. Plane's still circling. Yeah, so they blocked off the road. And at least they've talked to this person. They're having some sort of discussion. Oh, there's police vehicles behind everybody as well. So there's police vehicles moving along the that road up there where everyone was just at, it looks like. Going up behind this crew. Now, like a line of vehicles has moved up from where the people were praying along the dirt road. You see this kind of two armored vehicles in the front of the police line, and looks like they're moving the MRAP around. I think that's an MRAP. Might be another form of air cut. I'm not sure. So I think that's brand new. That's a new one. So they've moved the MRAP or the other armored vehicle across the road now, blocking it completely, and now they're bringing in the other Bearcat behind it, and now they've made a complete barrier on this road right here. And so now you have these vehicles that are lined up, aren't able to leave. And if I can look behind them, you can see there's police vehicles behind them now. So now they've kind of like grabbed everybody and they've locked them down on this road. Again, I want to make sure everyone was watching the live stream. If you please can tweet. Remember, I was sitting on my roof for the whole live event. That is exactly where I was, on this public road. People checked with the police officers if it was a public road. They said yes, and I haven't moved since then, and I've been steadily documenting what's been going on. So now, looks like the convoy is coming up. People are moving forward. One truck. And we'll see how this plays out. Looks like a helicopter overhead. They said. They said, tell everyone to stay right there again. So the police are. There's a person on the right door of the Bearcat has a marker round shooter, some sort of gas launcher. Kind of moved it around when everyone got closer. So now they have this hall completely blocked off. There is a route around through here, but it doesn't look like anyone's willing to take it. You see, this person's. Yeah, they're gonna try to arrest everybody. I'm gonna move back to my vehicle really quick. So yeah, so they've blocked off the road completely. And now they're moving vehicles quickly along. The road. So they're gonna try to arrest every person here, it looks like. I have to go turn off my vehicle and look it. Again, again, if you were watching the live stream, you know that I have not left this road. So I'm moving back, you see all these people gathered on this road. They're not letting people move fast. So it looks like people are pulling out horses now.
Live stream it!
What? No, they blocked the road completely.
Can you get around?
No.
You were all the way up there?
Yeah, well, I mean, if you really wanted to try. Alright, so, yeah, this is, there's a vehicle riot, put my windows up, alright. So, your horse goes by, and then you have these police vehicles. Here's the Bearcat. Here is the police policing in their vehicles. What's up?
They're gonna arrest us all.
Yep. That's their goal. And so it looks like, okay. Okay, it looks like they're letting people leave now.
Let's go!
So it looks like they're letting people leave. So they have riot shields. They've arrested somebody on the ground.
Stay back.
Please tell them to stay back. Move it up. You see a shotgun here that's not fluorescent? It looks like a normal shotgun. Officer with the shotgun! Is that less these little rounds?
Move back.
So they have shotguns that look like they're real shotguns. And now they're moving people back. going back. You can see shotguns here, here. Usually the last little rounds. Is that lethal ammunition? Yeah, you can
see.
You're blocking cars.
Yeah, cars. I'm blocking cars.
I don't, hey, hey. Yeah, so you have.
Drive forward.
You're blocking cars.
Yeah. No, we're not.
Yeah, it's a wrong. Cars. Please slide in front of cars.
So, yeah, so the police swung around, everyone behind him, and now has a police line trying to move people away. You're going to see people have been arrested. I'm going to leave. So we're going really aggressively to get the van.
How many people they arrest now?
So they all were armed with lethal, there was no less lethal weapons in this front line. You can see their shotguns are all lethally armed. They're not fluorescent. They're yelling. They're yelling pretty loud. Seem really agitated. They've had the perfect yellow with a shield. Alright, so let's learn from the Unicorn Riot. We just witnessed, I guess, the police come up and surround a group of people. For a minute, give me 1 second, just kind of doing a bunch of adjustments and I'm driving. Here, can you do me a favor? Let's aim this shit at my fucking stupid face. Okay, sorry. So we just had the police sort of follow a group of water protectors for a few hours, it looked like. And then the water protectors set up here, had another prayer at a construction site. You can see helicopters overhead. And then the longer they stayed, more and more police kind of showed up at the end of a hill. Eventually a Bearcat showed up, and then what looked like an MRAP against, I don't know, police vehicles that well, but it was another armored vehicle. When people tried to leave, they formed a line, didn't let them leave, and then the police shot around them. There's actually other police that came down a road from, I think, the southwest. And so the armored vehicle shot around, people got out. There's people who were arrested. I didn't witness any of them. I'm not sure how many people were arrested, but there was people who were definitely arrested. At that point, the police started telling people to move back, came out of their vehicles armed with assault rifles and what looked like shotguns with, usually there's beanbag rounds in them, but they're bright orange guns. These were not. They all looked like normal shotguns, and came out basically prepared to use them and started, they seemed prepared to use them. I mean, they're armed with them. And then started moving people back, yelling them to leave, and people basically just have left. And so, yeah, that's basically what just happened. Anyways, let me get this back real quick. I'm gonna go down. So this is Lawrence with Unicorn Riot. We are leaving the site of that direct action. We're gonna go down for a little bit. Again, if you want to support our work out here, please just donate what you can. Support our work on unicornriot.ninja. We'll be on the ground here to show you what develops as these protests and sort of protections and resistance against the Dakota Access Pipeline continue here in North Dakota. And also know that they're going on all over, at least along the pipeline route in Iowa as well. And yeah, just check out unicornriot.ninja. Hit that like button, hit that follow button, and we'll be back later. And hit that follow button. And we'll be back later.